Hello students, today let us start with English 1 new chapter, chapter 31, conjunctions. Open your page number 107. Look at these pictures. Simon is going to school. Susan is going to school. Simon and Susan are going to school. In the third sentence, the word and links the first and second sentences. Remember, words that link sentences, words or groups of words together are known as conjunctions. Students, see in the first sentence, Simon is going to school. Next, Susan is going to school. These are two different sentences. But in the third picture, you can see two sentences are joined together and made one sentence. And the word which are joining the sentence is and. So, words that links the sentence are known as conjunctions. A. Make similar sentences for these groups of pictures. Students, you can see in the picture, the dog is eating, the cat is drinking milk, and in the next picture, you can see the cat and the dog. So, first you have to write single sentence for first two pictures, then you have to join and write for the third one. So let us write the first one. The dog is eating bone. The cat is drinking milk. The dog is eating bone and the cat is drinking milk. Here and is used as a conjunction. Next, you can see in the picture, man is buying vegetables. In the next picture, there are many people. So, we have to join the sentence and write. So, let us write the first one. A man is buying vegetables. This is the first sentence. Next, a group of people is buying vegetables. This is collective noun. So, we are using is. And the last sentence is, a man and a group of people are buying vegetables. Next, you can see here two boys are playing cricket. So the first one, shall we write the sentence? Harish is playing cricket. Parag is playing cricket. Harish and Parag are playing cricket. The conjunction and is known as a coordinating conjunction. It joins two words, group of words or sentences which have equal importance. So here and is also known as coordinating conjunction. It is having equal importance to join two sentences. Okay. The other coordinating conjunctions are F for A and N nor B but O or Y at S so. So these are other conjunctions. You can remember them as fan boys. It's easy to remember them as fan boys. Remember, for used to denote reason. For example, she could not go to the show. For she did not have enough money. So we are using for to give some reasons. You can see in the example, she could not go for the show. Why? Because she did not have enough money. So we are using for. Next, and. And used to denote addition. For example, I bought my mother a scarf and she loved it. So we are using and to denote extra addition. That means we are adding one more sentence. So when we are joining one more sentence, we are using and. So I brought a scarf for my mother and she liked it or she loved it. Next, nor. Nor is used to denote and not. For example, Mamta didn't finish her essay nor did she finish her mathematics. Here you are comparing Mamta that she did not even finish her essay writing and she did not finish mathematics also. So instead of writing and not, we are using nor. Next, but. But is used to denote contrast. Contrast means different or difference. For example, I like coffee, but I don't like tea. Or used to denote option. For example, you can take a cruise to Greece or travel to Mexico. So what we are doing here, we are giving option. You can go by ship or you can go by any other travels, means of travels. So we are using or, that is option. At, used to denote outcome. For example, Rishi ate an entire cake, yet he was still hungry. So here, he ate full cake, but he was not happy. He was still hungry. His stomach was not filled. So we are using yet. Next, so, used to denote result. For example, Susan didn't have enough money to fly to London. So she took the train. So here we are using so to give out the results. You can see in the sentence, she did not have enough money, so she took the train. Okay, students, I hope you understood. Just read this carefully. Next, remember. Remember, a comma is used along with coordinating conjunctions to connect two independent sentences. So, comma is used to connect two different sentences, right? It is important to note that a comma is never placed after coordinating conjunctions. Here, comma is used before coordinating conjunctions. You know what are those coordinating conjunctions? They are nor, but, or, yet, and so on. Okay, you can see in the example. For example, Mimi ate two pastries, comma, but she was still hungry. So, after pastries, there's a comma and there's a conjunction. What it is? Coordinating conjunction, right? You must be quiet or you must leave the room. Tanu studied a lot, yet she didn't pass the result. So you can see before the coordinating conjunctions, there are the commas in those two sentences. Okay, let us move on to be mean. Fill in these blanks with appropriate conjunctions. Remember the word fanboys. Do you remember the words? They are for, and, nor, but, or, at, so. Okay. Now, first one. The drivers left the deserted station, dash headed for the next stop. It is what? What do you have to write? And. The drivers left the deserted station and headed for the next stop. Second. Charu is keen, dash Arpita is absolutely excited. So, the answer is but. Charu is keen, but Arpita is absolutely excited. Third, you need to leave dash. They will be forced to call the guards. Or, you need to leave or they will be forced to call the guards. Fourth, the little girl is sad, dash. She has lost her dog. The little girl is sad for she has lost her dog. Fifth, Ethan can take the money. Dash risk everything on the next question. Answer is or. Ethan can take the money or risk everything on the next question. Sixth, the teacher had reminded them about the homework. Dash, they had not done the work. And the answer is at. The teacher had reminded them about the homework. At, they had not done the work. Seventh, Myra had done very well in the exams. Dash, her parents took her out to Wonderland. Myra had done very well in the exams. So, her parents took her out to Wonderland. Next, eighth one, turn the page. He did not eat the lunch, dash did he have the snacks. He did not eat the lunch, nor did he have the snacks. 9th, should I go to the party? - should I visit grandmother? Should I go to the party or should I visit grandmother? And the 10th one, the team played very well. - lost the game. The team played very well but lost the game. Next, see, join these pairs of sentences with appropriate coordinating conjunctions. First one, the little bird flapped its wings. It flew away. The little bird flapped its wings and flew away. So we are using and here as a conjunctions. Next, second, Rishi called out to the taxi. It did not stop. Rishi called out to the taxi, but it did not stop. Third, he was punished. He was guilty. He was punished for he was guilty. Fourth, he is very rich. He is not happy. He is very rich, yet he is not happy. And we have used the word yet. Fifth, you can have a cake. You can have an ice cream. You can have a cake or an ice cream. Sixth, we were tired. We decided to rest. We were tired, so we decided to rest. Seventh, Radha is scared of dogs. Her little brother is not. Radha is scared of dogs, but her little brother is not. Eighth, Annie began to read the story. She read it right till the end. Annie began to read the story and read it right till the end. Ninth, we can order chicken curry and rice. We can order something vegetarian. We can order chicken curry and rice or something vegetarian. 10th, the weather was very cold. Rohit wore gloves. The weather was very cold, so Rohit wore gloves. Remember, another type of conjunction is the correlative conjunctions. These are words that are always used in pairs. So, another type is correlative conjunction. That is, the words are related to each other and they are always used in pairs. For example, both and. These are two words but they are related to each other and they will be used in the sentence. Not only but also either or. Neither nor whether or. They add one statement or fact to another. For example, both Manish and Mugdha are my students. So here you can see both and are used. So they are related to each other. He bought not only some flowers but also a cake for her birthday. So we are using not only but also. They are related to each other, right? To express a choice between two alternatives. For example, we will go either to the market or to the mall to buy the grocery. So here you can see we will go to market or we will go to mall. Neither Tarun nor Tanu attended the prize giving ceremony. I do not know whether I should add sugar or tea to this dish. So you can see the words which are correlated to each other in the sentences. When using correlative conjunctions, we must remember to use the same part of speech after each part of the pair of conjunctions. For example, I bought not only pastries but also brownies for the party. Here students, when you are writing correlative conjunctions, you should remember to use same part of speech after each pair of conjunctions. You can see it in the example here. Pastry is a noun. Brownie is also a noun. So, noun is used after not only. You can see I bought not only. Then pastry is written, that is noun. And after that, you can see after but also. After but also there is a noun. You can see that noun is brownie. You have to write this way. That is same part of speech. Next, I not only bought pastries but also brownies for the school. Here you can see verb after not only and noun after but also. So this is wrong sentence. You should always use same part of speech. Here it is not used. She is neither rich nor poor. Adjective after neither. Adjective after nor. Can you see? Okay, next. Neither she is rich nor poor. Here again they have used verb after neither. This is a wrong sentence. When we have to begin the sentence with the first part of the correlative conjunctions, this is how we should construct the sentence. Not only did I buy pastries, but I also bought brownies for the party. Can you see the difference in the first sentence? How to join two sentences? Neither she is rich nor she is poor. Thus, we are combining two sentences and hence maintaining the balance in the sentence. Next, remember, there is no need for commas before the correlative conjunctions within a sentence. So we are not adding any commas before this correlative conjunction words. Okay. Next, let us move on to demain. Fill in these blanks with appropriate coordinating conjunctions to complete the story. Once Mullah Nasiruddin arrived in a small town. At the plaza, he stopped at a fruit stand, dash admired the wonderful fruits for sale. These fruits look great, dash. I must try them, dash. Please give me a pound, he said to the vendor. He wanted to taste the delicious looking fruit. He wondered, should he go ahead, dash. Should he stop, dash, have some. He didn't want to get late. Dash, he couldn't stop thinking about the fruits. He looked around. There was no rest house. Dash, was there any house? Finally, he found a tree. Dash sat under it as he could no longer wait to eat the fruits. Now, let us fill these blanks with appropriate coordinating conjunctions. Once Mullah Nasiruddin arrived in a small town, at the plaza he stopped at a fruit stand and admired the wonderful fruits for sale. These fruits look great and I must try them. So please give me a pound, he said to the vendor. He wanted to taste the delicious looking fruit. He wondered, should he go ahead or should he stop and have some? He didn't want to get late, but he couldn't stop thinking about the fruits. He looked around. There was no rest house, nor was there any house. Finally, he found a tree and sat under it as he could no longer wait to eat the fruits. He took one fruit, closed his eyes, dash put it into his mouth. He thought he would taste something delicious. Dash, as soon as he took one bite, his mouth felt as if it was on fire. He turned beet red, dash, tears rolled down his cheeks, dash, he kept eating. A passerby saw this strange sight, dash, went up to him. Excuse me, he said, why are you eating red chilies like this? Oh, are these red chilies? I thought they were some fruit. Dash, I wanted to eat them. Dash, now I am eating them because I have paid for them. He took one fruit, closed his eyes, and put it into his mouth. He thought it would taste something delicious. And as soon as he took one bite, his mouth felt as if it was on fire. He turned beet red and tears rolled down his cheeks. But he kept eating. A passerby saw this strange sight and went up to him. Excuse me, he said, why are you eating red chilies like this? Oh, are they red chilies? I thought they were some fruit and I wanted to eat them. But now I am eating them because I have paid for them. E. Fill in the blanks with appropriate correlative conjunctions. There was a deserted island in the sea. Dash, were there any animals? Dash, were there any human beings? Only an old man whose name was Prospero and his daughter Miranda, a very beautiful young lady, lived on this island. Miranda had been so young when she had come to this island that she had forgotten Dash, where she was born, Dash, that she was actually a princess. She had no memory of Dash, her relatives, Dash, of her servants. In fact, she did not remember seeing any human face except her father's. However, Dash, Prospero, Dash, Miranda lived quite happily on the island. This was because the island had some spirits whom Prospero had helped. So, Dash, it was food they wanted, Dash, clothes. The spirits provided everything for them. One day, a ship got wrecked near the island, and many of the people on the ship swam to the island. Among them was a young prince, Ferdinand. Ferdinand was Dash, handsome, Dash, brave. When Miranda saw him, she wondered, Dash, he was a spirit, Dash, a god, because she had never seen a man before. Ferdinand, too, felt that Dash was Miranda, beautiful, Dash, she was, Dash, very intelligent. Dash, Ferdinand, Dash, Miranda noticed Prospero watching them. Prospero knew that he should, Dash, allow them to fall in love with each other. Dash, he should imprison the young man. What happened to the two young people? Did they fall in love? Did Prospero allow them to get married? Did they get off the island? If you want to know the whole story, read The Tempest by William Shakespeare. Now, students, let us fill in these blanks with correlative conjunctions. There was a deserted island in the sea. Neither were there any animals, nor were there any human beings. Only an old man, whose name was Prospero, and his daughter Miranda, a very beautiful young lady, lived on this island. Miranda had been so young when she had come to this island that she had forgotten not only where she was born, but also that She was actually a princess. She had no memory of either her relatives or of her servants. In fact, she did not remember seeing any human face except her father's. However, both Prospero and Miranda lived quite happily on the island. This was because the island had some spirits whom Prospero had helped. So, whether it was food they wanted or clothes, the spirits provided everything for them. One day, a ship got wrecked near the island, and many of the people on the ship swam to the island. Among them was a young prince, Ferdinand. Ferdinand was both handsome and brave. When Miranda saw him, she wondered whether he was a spirit or a god, because she had never seen a man before. Ferdinand, too, felt that not only was Miranda beautiful, but she was also very intelligent. Neither Ferdinand nor Miranda noticed Prospero watching them. Prospero knew that he should either allow them to fall in love with each other or he should imprison the young man. Next, F-men. Combine these pairs of sentences with appropriate correlative conjunctions. First one, here students, we have to join these both the sentence and form a single sentence. So the first one is, I want to buy a pen. I want to buy a notebook. Here we are going to join both the sentence and make one sentence. That is, I want to buy both a pen and a notebook. Or, I want to buy not only a pen but also a notebook. Or, I want to buy either a pen or a notebook. Students, here I have used and, not only, but, either, or I have used. You can write any one sentence among these. Second, this plant does not have any flowers. This plant does not have any fruit. This plant has neither any flowers nor any fruit. Third, Archie is my friend. Joseph is my friend. Both Archie and Joseph are my friends. Fourth, the zebra is not dangerous. The horse is not dangerous. Neither the zebra nor the horse is dangerous. Fifth, the boys play football every evening. The boys play cricket every evening. The boys play football and cricket every evening. Or the boys play not only football but also cricket every evening. Or the boys play either football or cricket every evening. Students, you can write any one sentence among these. Sixth, please tell me if I have passed the exams. Please tell me if I have not passed the exams. Please tell me whether I have passed the exams or not. Seventh, we will sell the house. We will sell the land. We will sell both the house and the land. Or we will not only sell the house but also the land. Or we will either sell the house or the land. You can write any one sentence. Eighth, my mother has not packed the toothbrush. My mother has not packed the toothpaste. My mother has packed neither the toothbrush nor the toothpaste. Ninth, Gunjan will come first in the class this time. Henna will come first in the class this time. Either Gunjan or Henna will come first in the class this time. And 10th, the farmer bought the ducks. The farmer bought the chicks. The farmer bought both the ducks and the chicks. Or the farmer bought not only the ducks but also the chicks. There is a third kind of conjunction called the subordinating conjunction, but we will learn about this later. G. Underline the conjunctions in these sentences. Students, you have to underline the conjunctions. This is for homework. Write this main in your homework book. Next, H. Use and, but, or, because to join these sentences. First one, she is always late. She is the best student in the class. And the answer is, she is always late, but she is the best student in the class. We have used but. Second, I do not really like spaghetti. I can eat lasagna any day. Here spaghetti and lasagna are pastas. It is a dish. So the answer is, I do not really like spaghetti, but I can eat lasagna any day. Third, we were late for the cinema. Sham came late from school. We were late for the cinema because Sham came late from school. Fourth, she is getting good grades. She is studying very hard. She is getting good grades because she is studying very hard. Fifth, he wanted to go for the picnic. His mother refused. He wanted to go for the picnic, but his mother refused. Sixth, the tomato soup is spicy. It is delicious. The tomato soup is spicy, but it is delicious. Seventh, I take sprouts for breakfast. I take fresh fruits for breakfast. I take sprouts for breakfast and fresh fruits for breakfast. Eighth, those people cannot read. They cannot write. Those people cannot read or write. I. Fill in the blanks using appropriate conjunctions from the box given below. Some can be used twice. First one. We stopped dash bought some bread and eggs on our way. We stopped and bought some bread and eggs on our way. Second. I complained against them dash they lied to me. I complained against them because they lied to me. Third, she wants dash the cake dash the pie. She wants either the cake or the pie. Fourth, my brother is fond of me dash he annoys me often. My brother is fond of me though he annoys me often. Fifth, his new home is dash comfortable dash very spacious. His new home is not only comfortable but also very spacious. Sixth, I had no choice dash to sign the contract. I had no choice but to sign the contract. Seventh, dash Misha dash Ruma are going for the poetry meet. Both Misha and Ruma are going for the poetry meet. Eighth, would you like cake dash cookies with your tea? Would you like cake or cookies with your tea? Ninth, dash dinner will go for a walk. After dinner, we'll go for a walk. And 10th, we can dash go to the market dash to the cafe. We can either go to the market or to the cafe. This is the end of the chapter. Thank you.